Okay, so Elsa in Octofallen is battling the Nog. And she's on the Soul Sand. Like, her mom's, or like, whoever has her voice says, "Step into your power," when she's in Octofallen, like, when she's actually inside of it. And so, like, it's also really interesting because, like, the Wind Spirit, like, literally, like, picks Elsa up and envelops her in this, like, wind-like ball. And so what she's in Octofallen might not actually be like where she's like intended to like go or stay, but like it is interesting because I mean the movie ends that like that, but then like we also see Isabella and the Encanto after that, and then like Raya. So like, I don't know which of how many of these characters are actually Elsa or some incarnation of Elsa, but it is interesting because like Octofallen itself. I mean, her mom even tells her what Octofallen is, and then she goes there. But then she also makes these, like, water memories from the ship that she's in. And so, it's really interesting because, like, when she goes to Octofallen, she probably made the Nog, and she also probably made Octofallen itself. And, like, the glacier that she's in is probably, like, where she gets enveloped in it, like, the wind spirit envelops her in that wind ball. And then Octofallen and the wind spirit, it actually seems like all four of the spirits like are kind of enveloping her in some capacity. Because like she's walking on that soul sand, and then like the Octofallen says, "Step into your power." And it's like Octofallen says, "Step into your power," which like might be referencing the soul sand on the beach. Like right before she gets to Octofallen. And then when she's actually in there, so like that's a reference to Earth. And then like she battles the water spirit, which is like that is the water spirit. So like that's two. The wit like they're in the show yourself scene is like wind. So like that's three. And then when she goes to like she backs Bruni into a corner. And so, like, I wonder if the fire spirit is, like, in there. Because, I mean, you don't see the fire spirit in there, like, as, like, clearly as that. But, like, you see, like, this vision with her and the Northolter leader. And then she, like, gets fully frozen. So, is that what's happening? Is that she, like, because again, like, this whole thing is about her thawing while she's in there. And, like, she can use all of the, like, powers of each of the spirits, I think. Because she becomes the fifth spirit, but then she has to master her power. And then like Octofallen itself is reacting to her like as she's in there. Because it like all four of the spirits I think envelops her in there. But it seems like she probably has to master the fire spirit because like that's probably how she thaws herself. Because again, I think she has to thaw herself out of this situation. And like her hair kind of looks like sand, and TNT in the Minecraft game is sand. So like I wonder if she has to like thaw herself by like mastering her fire power. But like it also is really interesting because like Anna says that she is sensing like rising anger in her. And then like Olaf says, oh no, actually, I don't know if Anna even says that. Olaf says, "I'm sensing rising anger in me." And like Olaf, like Anna thinks that she's talking about her, but Olaf is talking about himself. So like I wonder if that's what's happening, if it's like Elsa, like like she's at the very least wearing like a water ice dress. So like Olaf says that he's sensing rising anger in him. He's a snowman. So like her dress is an ice dress, and she has the transformation, which is a white dress, when before she had like a light blue one that was kind of more like ice. So I wonder if like Olaf is like what that is that it's like her dress, like she's probably having rising anger. And so like in the scene with King Runard where she's seeing the like this like you know like frost depiction of like King Runard in the Northolter leader, like she's probably having rising anger, like what Olaf was experiencing. And like that's when you see like that wind chill like creeping up her like body, like I think that that's what that is. It's like it's rising anger in her. And then, like, as she does that, Atahala envelops her more. Like, the four, just, like, she's in there with the four spirits. And, like, even the Nock, she battled the Nock to get in there, and the Nock was pretty aggressive. she battled the Nock to get in there, but, like, just like Agnar said, and she even sees Agnar, and then Iduna says, not too far or you'll be drowned. Like, dive down deep into the sound, but not too far or you'll be drowned. And so she sees Agnar and Iduna, which presumably is, like, herself. And then, like, she sees, like, Agnar as herself. And then she sees the Northuldra leader and King Runar, which is also, like, the Northuldra leader is probably also herself, because that Agnar probably is the Northuldra leader. But I think that that's what the dam is that, like, King Runar built this dam, kind of like Callaghan had a mask, so that, like, he could really, like, and also how Gothel was gaslighting Rapunzel, but then also, like, pretending to be nice to her. So, like, the spirits are probably in some capacity doing that, or it's just, like, Elsa's power is that she also is a very little bit like that. Like, she's probably a very little bit like Mother Gothel, and a very little bit like King Runar. And when she does, when she, like, is, like, displaying that sort of, like, those, like, character traits, then, like, Atahala itself, like, herself, reacts to her the way that she would probably react out of fear to these people that she knows. So, like, that actually makes a ton of sense. And, like, that's what it is. That's, like, she's lets her guard down because she believes that the Nock is not there. But I think that that's actually the point, is that, like, an iceberg, like, a glacier is, like, I don't know if it's, like, 90%, but most of a glacier is underwater. And it's, like, the subconscious. And so, like, most of the glacier is underwater. And so, like, the Nock, like, the water, like, recedes, and the Nock, like, goes into the water. But, like, all of that, like, dark sea is Atahala, I think. And so, like, that actually makes a lot of sense, because Elsa sees Agnar, and then she, like, is just kind of, like, enjoying the, you know, like, the wind chill in there or whatever. But, like, then, like, what happens is, like, her power is triggering these things, and then, like, the Nock, just, like, her presence, like, she arrived to the sea, and then, like, either built the Nock, and then, like, it started being aggressive with her, or the Nock was already there, and she was, like, encroaching on it. But still, like, whichever of those things is actually accurate, like, she actually is arriving there, and she lets her guard down after seeing Agnar, and, like, having this dress transformation. Which, again, Agnar is probably very much, like, the spirit of the Enchanted Forest or something. And so, like, Elsa, if she is this water spirit and is, like, is the, like, heart of Atahala or whatever, then it makes a lot of sense that, like, while she's in there, A, she doesn't really know what it is, or she's just been gone from it for a long time, and so, like, she doesn't know how to, like, interact with it, like, properly. And, like, it's also maybe, like, bees and, like, with a new queen, like, she's in this, like, closed in space because, like, she's like a bee, and so, like, Atahala in itself is what, you know, the equivalent of that. So Atahala in itself is, like, attacking her periodically, like, depending on what she does. And so, like, I think that that makes a ton of sense, like, that that's what's happening in Atahala, is that, like, she's having this, like, rising anger in her. And then, like, you even see, like, when she gets fully frozen, and, like, when Anna gets frozen in the first movie, like, there's that little bit of, like, wind that escapes her. And so, like, I think that that's kind of what's happening, is that, like, she's in there, and when, like, that rising anger, when she, like, can't hold it back anymore, because that's what happened, let it go. But, like, when she's in Atahala and she can't, like, hold it back anymore, that's, like, what Iduna meant about, like, not too far or you'll be drowned. Because, like, when she can't hold it back anymore, she, like, provokes the, like, Atahala, and then, like, it reacts to her. And so, like, I think that that's what it is. Like, it's, like, a self-fulfilling prophecy. And so, like, she has to not do that while she's in there, because she let her guard down, because she believes that the Nock, whether it is herself or not, is not there. And so, like, I think that that's what it is. But, like, because it's a glacier, like, the Nock, all it did was just go back into the water. But the Nock is the water, and, like, she is Atahala, and so, like, the Nock is there, like, battling her, but she doesn't think that, she doesn't, either, because, I mean, she knows that she's in Atahala, and she doesn't know what Atahala is, necessarily, but, like, she knows that, like, But, like, she's in there, and she knows that there is, like, even when she's following King Runard, like, when she's diving down deep into the sound or whatever, like, she sees her mom, and I don't know if she knows that it's not her mom, but, like, she sees her mom in there, and, like, maybe she even, like, when she froze the knock, maybe she even, like, froze her mom or something, and, like, her mom is actually in there, or someone is actually in there, and she has them, like, subdued, possibly. But, like, it is interesting, because she doesn't know that, like, the knock is actually what she's interacting with. And, like, I think that that's what it is. And so, like, the knock, I think, is, like, chill with her, but, like, she is, like, it probably isn't, like, totally chill with her. And so, like, she has to not provoke it, I think, is what's happening. But, like, because she didn't know that that it was in there, or, like, she didn't know that, like, that whole dark sea was, like, that spirit, like, I think that that's what it is that she knows that there's something hostile in Atahalan, but, like, she doesn't know that it is literally the knot. Like, she thinks that she's not battling the knot, and she thinks that this hostile thing that she's seeing is something else, but it's the knot. And, like, I think that that's what it is. So she doesn't realize that she's having the same battle in Atahalan that she was having in the Dark Sea. It's the same battle. Like, she thinks that the battle is over because she let her guard down the same way Agnar did. And, like, I think that that's what it actually is. And so that's also good, because, like, you have to know your opponent to battle it. And so, like, now that she knows, like, now that I know that Atahalan is actually the knock, and that whole Dark Sea and the glacier is just something that the knock, like, the water spirit, swooped her up in, just like the wind spirit swooped her up in the forest. It's the same thing. And it's also really interesting, because maybe that means that Arendelle itself is something that, like, the rock trolls swooped her up into. So the rock trolls probably swooped Elsa up into Arendelle, and, like, when she was living in Arendelle, that was just the same thing as her being swept up by the wind spirit and the water spirit in Atahalan. And then, like, the fire spirit, I don't know if we actually literally see her get swooped up in fire at any point. I mean, the forest does get set on fire, but it is interesting, because the forest gets set on fire when she's with, like, the whole gang or whatever. But then, like, at the end of the story, she's interacting with Bruni, and he's, like, you know, bouncing on the trees and stuff, but he doesn't set anything on fire, because she actually learned how to, like, interact with these things. So, like, I think that that's what it is. It's, like, each of the spirits at some point in time did actually swoop her up. Like, and I think all of them in Frozen 2. Like, her literally just being in Arendelle is being swooped up by the rock trolls. Anna also gets swooped up by the rock trolls. But, like, it's, people didn't realize that these are all the same thing. The wind spirit really swoops her up twice. Because, like, the wind spirit specifically swoops her up in the small ball. But, like, the, her going into the forest, into the mist itself, is that too. So, like, all of the spirits swoop her up at some point in time in the film, and she has to realize that she's battling all of them, even though she thinks that she is, like, not battling them. I think that's the whole point of what the river is. And just like Hades can make these, like, smoke illusions of, like, her, like, loved ones or whatever, and she has to, like, remember who she is so that she can remember what her power is, like, because, like, a lot of her power is, like, she's so much more powerful than she knows that she is, but, like, that's because a lot of this stuff, like, she doesn't remember. But then, like, another thing is that, like, she has to remember that, like, she knows how to, like, take care of herself as well. Like, she knows how to take care of herself, but she makes these kind of stupid decisions because she lets her guard down, and she makes these stupid decisions because she doesn't remember who she is, and she doesn't remember, like, some of the negative things that, like, got her to the situation that she's in. And so, like, I think that that's kind of what it is. But yeah, no, that's super interesting. But yeah, like, you see that, like, ice creeping up her, like, hair, and, like, the sand in her hair is, like, turning ice, and, like, I think that's what it is. It's rising anger in her, and when that anger is rising in her, which is the whole point of the dam, because King Runar built the dam because he was trying to get the spirits to turn their magic on him. But, like, she, I think, created, like, because even, like, I wrote things that, like, manifested this, like, she said show yourself, like, movie show times. Like, she said show yourself. So, like, I'm like, I designed this, like, movie. And, like, it's not, like, I designed this movie and kind of presented it to see if people would, like, actually, like, film it or whatever. And so, like, what's happening is, like, the film is pointing out, like, they brought me to, like, the set or whatever. And, like, they're having me show myself my power, like, directing, writing, acting. Like, they're having me show myself my power and, like, the power of this process. And, like, that is this process. It's the film that I submitted. That they're, like, A, testing, but then also that they're, like, making. And so, like, I think that that's what it is. It's movie magic. Like, the North Ultra follow magic. So she arrives to a place of movie magic, just kind of like Lion King. But, like, the way that it's being operated is not, like, it's just like if we're, it's just like if, like, when Simba returns to Pride Rock and, like, Sarabi is, like, married to Scar, but she doesn't want to be. But, like, that's how the world works. Like, money. A lot of these people are married to people that they don't want to be married to because of money. And so, like, I think that that's what's happening. She has to be aware that, like, there is a, like, whatever the power vacuum is that she's going there to fill, like, whoever was ruling there, whoever has the frozen heart, even, like, in the Southern Isles with the, like, the Frozen 3, like, atlas that I, like, submitted, like, I think that that's also what it is. It's, like, you have to be aware that, like, even though some of the people in here might be on your side, like, the, like, we haven't actually, like, arrived at the solution, and we haven't actually arrived at the conclusion yet, but, like, they are, like, observing your power, like, and having you show yourself your power, but, remember, it's all in the confines of, like, what the inaccurate, like, leadership is, or whatever. Whoever is the king that, like, in Lion King, like, Simba returns as the rightful king, but he also has to battle the person who, like, you know, like, stole his life from him. Just like Ursula steals voices, like, Eric has to go and battle Ursula. It doesn't just, like, happen. And so, like, I think that that's kind of what's happening. Is, like, she also doesn't even know, like, where in the movie she is. But, like, I think that that's what it is. But, like, being aware of that, like, she can, like, guide herself to, like, where she needs to be. Because, like, if she, by realizing that this is her design. And, like, when she does that, like, she, like, that's what thawing herself is. Because, like, it was her rising anger that froze her, or, like, that, like, fostered the situation that froze her. But, like, if she realizes that she is the four spirits, and then, like, she learns how to, like, connect with that fire spirit power, because she puts Bruni in the snow and then thaws, like, presumably to thaw the forest, and there's also light there, and, like, she puts Bruni there, and then, like, she sees, like, the sun in Ahtohallin. So, like, I don't know how her putting Bruni there, like, created that, but she probably did. And I think that that's also what it is, because her putting herself in Ahtohallin, like, thaws it. Like, when she goes there, like, and she realizes that she can master her power, which, again, is kind of like taking the redstone torch, you know? So, like, it's, like, heat. But, like, when she, and also, like, Riley, like, the journey to bring Riley home. Like, Riley, the other story was about Riley's emotions, and we even see these, like, all these blue orbs in, Wish. But, like, there's, like, a transition of, like, that character being kind of absorbed into Disney Animation, and then, like, people remembering that, like, Hades has those blue orbs as well. So it's, like, are those sad memories, or are they, like, prophecies that were in the River Styx and the Hercules? So, like, I think that that's kind of what's happening, is, like, she's aware of, like, where she is in time, and she's aware of, like, where she is in her life, but, like, all of society and all of the world that she's in has not caught up to that. And so, like, sometimes when she's just, like, living, people will, like, interject, or, like, she will, like, have an emotion or say something that, like, is, like, then spurs people to, like, say something to her. That, because they're not at the same place that she is, she has to remember that, she has to be aware that she has to, like, put on this show. That's what it is in the first place, to show yourself, put on a show. So, like, Ahtohallin is, like, reacting to her when she's, like, A, breaking character, or letting her guard down to her detriment, or whatever. And so, like, I think that that's kind of what it is, like, like, whoever had my voice is, like, trying to teach me how to, like, restore it, and then, like, teach me how to, like, utilize remembering who I am, because I remembered who I was, but, like, then I have to remember how to be who I am. I think it's kind of what's happening, and remember that the fates are trying to cut my string here, or whatever the situation is. It's similar to the River Six situation. And so, like, something like that may be happening, and I have to just be aware that I'm in here with three people. So even if that's not what's happening, I have to be aware that that's the most similar thing that I have to go off of from memory of what happens in Olympus with kidnapped people as they try to cut their string. Like, that's the movie magic memory version of this that I have. And so, like, that's what I have to go off of as far as, like, that's what caution is. It's like you're being cautious, is knowing that something has happened to you before, and like not having it happen again, and like not provoking the situation that causes that to happen, even if it's not justified, and even if it, like, no one has any reason to actually do that to you, they might do it anyways. And so, like, I think that that's kind of what it is. But yeah, so like it is just really interesting. So she learns in here that she can thaw herself. But again, just like she doesn't really know that she made the knock, like that she probably made the knock just the same way that she made Olaf, she doesn't know that. So she, the mom, like, or Iduna, Atahal, and whatever, it says you are the one you've been waiting for. She's probably trying to get her to remember that she built Olaf. Remember that. There's a river full of memory. She's trying to get her to remember that she built Olaf. And so she's, like, kind of waiting for, like, the knock to come and save her. Because, like, she's seen that, like, either, like, again, she doesn't know how much of this is her own design. So, like, she's probably waiting for the knock to come and save her, but she doesn't really realize that she actually saved herself. And, like, she doesn't realize that, like, these things are things that she manifested with her power. And so, like, I think that that's what's happening, is that it's, like, once she realizes that she said something that led to her getting frozen, but then she learned, just like she learned how to, like, chill Bruni out, she, like, also thawed herself, and, like, she's not waiting for the knock to come back and, like, save her, because she either is the knock, or the knock is just, a manifestation of her power that she can just create at some point, and then she can go, like, wherever she needs to go. So she's not waiting on the knock, she's waiting for herself to remember how she built the knock, and she's waiting for herself to remember how she got frozen. She's waiting for herself to remember how she thought herself after she froze herself. Like, I think that that's kind of what it is. Because again, like, her getting frozen is not, like, no one is freezing her, but she gets frozen when she, like, has an interaction with someone that is, like, negative or whatever. And so, like, she gets frozen when that happens. So, like, she can have an interaction with somebody, but then she gets frozen, but then she learns how to thaw herself. So, like, that's probably what the light is when she's going to Atahan at the end of the movie. That's probably why the sun is there, because she has realized at that point that she doesn't have to be scared of going to Atahan, because she knows that it's her that has the power to thaw it. And she knows that it's her that has the power to, like, summon the knock. And so, like, once she knows that, that's who she is. That's what becoming the fifth spirit is that she knows that she can command the power of all four of the spirits, so that when she does get herself into these jams, she knows how to get herself out. I think that that's actually the whole point of what's happening in Atahan, which is actually really interesting. But yeah, okay, so that's, I think that that's what that is. But yeah, but also, like, she also doesn't need the knock, I don't think. I think that that's also the point, because she says step into her power, into your power, but just like she kind of thinks it's her mom that's talking to her, even though it might just be not her mom at all, or, like, just, like, her mom's, her own voice being spoken through her mom. But, like, it's, and that's, I think that's the point, too, because she's in there, and she's watching ice. Like, it's literally something that she made with ice, but it's her voice talking to her. And so, like, I think that's what it is, because it's, like, even if somebody has your voice, that's what, like, thinking that that is you because they are speaking with your voice, or, like, saying something that you either directed them to say or something that they stole, I think that that's really the same thing. Is that, like, she's watching that, and she thinks that it's... Because she's aware of how, like, so, like, somebody, like, has her voice, and so, like, they're, like, she knows that it's her design, but she's, like, not fully awake and not fully aware of it. And so, like, being awake is, like, not, like, provoking anything that is not necessary, and it's not, like, behaving out of character, and it's not, like, drawing attention to yourself or calling attention to yourself. Like, don't give anybody a reason to, like, have a negative situation be present. And, like, I think that that's kind of what it is. And so, like, she also has to remember that, like, she doesn't really need the knot. I think that that's kind of what it is. Even though she, A, has to remember that she can summon the knot once she learns how to master that power. But she also has to remember that she doesn't need the knot. Because she was, like, there are things that, like, she thinks that she needs because, like, A, it might be, like, faster. Or, like, things that she thinks that she needs because, like, there might be things that she thinks that she needs because, like, when she was battling the Nog, like, when she was going into the, like, into the sea, she, like, was battling the ocean, and, like, it was just her and the ocean and, like, the sand, like, the soul sand. And, like, she, and then the Nog is, like, manifested while she's battling it, but just, like, she made Olaf and didn't really know that it was, that was, that she built it, and she doesn't really know how it's, like, sentient. I think that that's kind of the same thing that's happening with the Nog, but she also learned how to tame it. So I think maybe it being sentient is her not being aware that she can command it. And so, like, once she learns how to command it, maybe that's her becoming aware that it isn't actually sentient. It's not actually, it's, like, just like her ice dress, like, she's wearing that. But it's really just water. It's just a water dress that she, like, has on. And so, like, I think that's what it is. She just has to realize that it's as much part of her as, like, the dress that she's wearing. It's just an ice thing that she, like, has on because, like, she, like, it's just, like, an accessory that she has on. I think that's literally what it is. But, like, she doesn't need the Nog. And, like, so she has these, like, false beliefs about what she, like, needs in her life. Or what she's waiting for in her life, when really all she needs is herself, and, like, she just needs, like, the bravery to do things, and, like, a little bit of, like, guidance, but, like, I think that that's really what it is. She doesn't really need that much. She just needs to, like, not, like, create negative situations, but she also just needs to master her power, and then, like, be as patient as she can within the confines of the world that she's in. That is crazy. Okay. But maybe that's something for Frozen 3, is that, like, in Frozen 3, we may see that she, like, because, again, in the first movie, she, is walking, like, she steps into the water, and then she, like, goes across the fjord or whatever, and into the mountains, and, like, the fjord freezes, because, like, that's, it's, like, she's very scared, I think, but, like, she has to realize that, like, it froze, but she also knows how to thaw it, but I think that she also has to realize that she can walk on the water without making a, like, force that she is actually just, like, that's her power. Like, she made the Nog, she made Olaf. So it is, like, even when she was, like, going to Atahualin, she thinks that she's riding the Nog to Atahualin, but, like, she's still walking on the water. She was walking on the water in the first movie, she was walking on the water in the second movie, but she thinks that she's walking on ice, because she turned it into ice because she was scared. I think that that's what it is. So in Frozen 3, which just like how I knew that there was actually going to be a third Frozen movie because of the logo, it was halfway thawed. And like, it very obviously looks like there's going to be a third movie because the thing isn't thawed. And so, and then, what do you know, they announced the third movie. So like, I think that that's kind of what's happening. So it's like, she just has to be aware. And, like, I think in the third movie, we're gonna see that she can just walk on the water. Like, that's probably what it is. Like, she literally can just walk on that water. And, like, even though there's, like, a little bit of, like, light on it, like, she can walk on that water. That's the whole point. I stepped into the water, into a puddle the other day. Olaf said, put me in summer, and I'll be a happy snowman, like, a puddle. Like, I think that that's the point, is that she's having to realize that she can walk on water. That's literally the point. Is that she doesn't need to turn it into ice to walk on it. She doesn't need to, like, make a horse to gallop on it. But she thinks she needs that stuff because, like, that's how it's worked before. And that's, like, that, like, is the like, the human way of, like, looking at it is it's like, oh, I need this, like, water horse so that I can, like, glide across this water or whatever. It's like, she doesn't need that. She can just walk on it. But she doesn't, like, fully know who she is or believe that she is who she is. I think that that's literally the whole point. That's crazy.